Eleisoni mes, Othios, Opatir, Opantukrator, Pan Agia Tries, Eleisoni mes, Ipsoisif Notin Tini Gom, Shopiniman, Gemon, Anton, and Ovo Isos, Henenes Lepsis, Nenen Hoke, Gifid Eruk, O Lord, makes worthy to pray thankfully, our Father who art in heaven. Samhoni Shli el Eflogi son Irene Pasi. Marin Chippe Motin Totfim Berif, Erbithlanif, O Hennait, if not if you tim penchois, O open noti, O open sutir, Iso O spi echeristus, G of Eris Kipazinigun, of Ervoithinirun, of Arih Eron, of Shoptineruf, of Tiasu Eron, Of Titotin of Intensha Ehri Eta Ay Uno Thai Enethuf On Mar Intiho Eruf Hoppons Entif Areh Erun Chen pai, eho es o apfai, نمنه اوتيرو انت بن اونخ خين هيريني نيفين انجي بي بانتو كراتو اور بشويس بن نوتي
برو سيبك سايستيم كيريانا
O Master Lord God the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for everything, concerning everything and in everything, for you have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
Pray that God may have mercy and compassion upon us. Hear us, help us, and accept the supplications and prayers of his saints for that which is good in our behalf at all times, and to keep the life and standing of our honored father, the Archpriest Pope of Atuadros the Second, and his partners in the apostolic liturgy, our father, the Bishop of Yusuf, and our father, the Bishop of Peter, and forgive us our sins.
Lord have mercy.
Therefore, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind, grant us to complete this holy day and all the days of our life in all peace with your fear, all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel of wicked men, and the rising up of enemies hidden and manifest. Take them away from us and from all your people and from this church and from this your holy place. But those things which are good and profitable do provide for us, for it is you have given us the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and upon all the power of the enemy.
Emmanuel,
share in our joy, Senor.
يوسف نوى بيصار نيك كيني من ما تدرو اوهي جنو اثرونوس
يتنمي وزين بيتي هوشوكوس سواء مريا شوي صاريهم وطنانم بيطوري قولن بيهن النومي اثرين
Irene Pasi
نسأل الله ضابط الكل أبو ربنا وإلهنا مخلصنا يسوع المسيح نسأل ونطلب من صلاحك يا محب البشر اذكر يا رب أنفس عبيدك أبينا أخوتنا الذين راقدوا
Pray for our fathers and our brethren who have fallen asleep and repose in the faith of Christ since the beginning. Our only fathers, the archbishops, our fathers, the bishops, our fathers, the hegumens, our fathers, the priests, our brethren, the deacons, our fathers, the monks, and our fathers, the laymen, and for the full repose of Christians, that Christ our God may repose all their souls in the paradise of joy, and we too accord mercy unto us and forgive us our sins.
Ya Rabbi.
Graciously, O Lord, repose all their souls in the bosom of our holy fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Sustain them in a green pasture beside the still waters in the paradise of joy, the place out of which grief, sorrow, and groaning have fled away in the light of your saints. Raise up their bodies also on the day which you have appointed according to your true promises which are without lie. Grant them the good things of your promise and that which an eye has not seen nor ear heard. Neither have come upon the heart of man the things which you, O God, have prepared for those who love your holy name. For there is no death for your servant, but a departure. Even if they, any negligence or heedlessness overtaken them as men, since they were clothed in flesh and dwelt in this world, O God, add the good one and lover of mankind, grant graciously accord, O Lord, to repose and forgive them, your servant, the Orthodox Christians who are in the whole world, from the east to the west and from the south to the north, each one according to his name and each one according to her name. For no one is pure and without blemish, even though his life on earth be a single day. As for those, O Lord, whose souls you have taken, repose them, and may they be worthy of the kingdom of heaven. As for us all, grant us our Christian perfection that would be pleasing to you, and give them and us a share and inheritance with all your saints.
Lord, have mercy.
Graciously accord, O Lord, to keep us this night with
without sin. Blessed are you, O Lord, God of our fathers, and exceedingly blessed and glorified be your name forever. Amen. Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us according to our hope in you. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food in due season. Hear us, O God, our Savior, the hope of all the regions of the earth. And you, O Lord, keep us safe from this generation and forever. Amen. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Blessed are you, O Lord, make me to understand your commandments. Blessed are you, O Lord, enlighten me with your righteousness. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not, O Lord, the works of your hands. You have been my refuge from generation to generation. I asked the Lord and said, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Lord, I have fled unto you. Save me and teach me to do your will. For you are my God, and with you is the fountain of life. In your light shall we see light. Let your mercy come unto those who know you, and your righteousness unto the upright in heart. To you belongs blessing, to you belongs praise, to you belongs glory. O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, existing from the beginning, now and forever and ever. Amen. It is good to give thanks to the Lord and sing praises unto your name, O Most High, to show forth your mercy every morning and your righteousness every night. Holy God,
Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, who was born of the Virgin, have mercy on us.
Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, who was crucified for us, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, who rose from the dead and ascended into the heavens, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of the ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, forgive us our sins. O Lord, forgive us our iniquities. O Lord, forgive us our trespasses. O Lord, visit the sick of your people. Heal them for the sake of your holy name. Our Father and brethren who have fallen asleep, O Lord, repose their souls. O you who are without sin, Lord, have mercy on us. O you who are without sin, Lord, help us and receive our supplications. For yours is the glory, the dominion, and triple holiness. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, bless us. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from the evil one. Christ Jesus, our Lord, present.
Et notte teb genus in tete metromi.
Intercede on our behalf before Christ, whom you bore, that he may forgive us our sins.
Serene.
Remember us, so our faithful advocate,
before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
Michael, barchon nanifiowi, en sofet oyensho, enni taksis namgilikon, efshemshem beemso emefchoish.
God sends unto us his mercy and compassion, through the supplications of Michael, the great archangel.
Samgokevon jani karbos, henentan tobem Michael, jen sofet chentechon efnoti, eftio eriegon.
All good honor and every perfect gift comes to us from on high, from the Father of light.
Mare noho sentention, tenos sentis reasis oab et oyen, Amos Yosis min evol shayene.
Intercede on our behalf, O holy archangel, Michael, head of the heavenly, that he may forgive us our sins.
Avamar chashvin arshi angelos, seo erato verem nos, embem som bem bando erator, Shem Shem Master Yonetim.
Michael is the first, Gabriel is the second, Raphael is the third, a symbol of the Trinity.
Soriel Sadakiel Sarasiel Nemananiel Nainishten Refroinesova Netobem Overiejem Bisol.
The cherubim and the seraphim, the thrones, dominions and powers, the four incorporeal creatures carrying the throne of God.
Gotev to Amaberez, which Eros Hintekle, Sayantishor, Bemisivo, Serof, and Ometatmon, O Shivon, if Goemon.
Holy God, heal the sick. Holy Mighty, repose those asleep in the Lord.
Agios Asanatos, Esmoetic Lironomeia. Mare pek nainem tek hirin, oyen soptem pek laos.
Holy, 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 O Lord of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory and honor.
Avshangos ambi alleluia, sharin anif yawa wemmo, jagios amin alleluia, pio fa penno tipe.
Intercede on our behalf, O angelic armies and heavenly orders, that he may forgive us our sins.
Ava Marcos be apostolos, O be evangelistis, be misrechaniem kaventa be monogris en noti.
You have come and enlightened us through your gospel, and taught us the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Akenten volchen epka ki echun epi oinem biatimon boikente bon et avie besite volchen et fe.
All the tribes of the earth were blessed through you, and your words have reached the ends of the world.
Yaakov martiro, shere bi evangelisti, shere bi avos, ava Marcos bi theorimon.
Pray to the Lord on our behalf, O beholder of God, the evangelist, Saint Mark the apostle, that he may forgive us our sins.
Akshi et chareis em moisis, temet o eben temet shi sedek, akshi em eptayom ben yod petros, be an agok and apostolos.
Christ lifted his right hand on your head. He gave you the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
I think so bin oref erhim isaib shoit ecclesia eterek amonem peklaos chanoto vonim omes mi.
Christ is also.
O αυτός την ηχήση εμόκ, νεμπία εμνόδος Δαβίδ, γεν σοκ πεπιό ευψάι, κατά ετάξης εμελσίσεδε.
Pray to the Lord on our behalf. O my Father, the Patriarch, our Holy Father, Abatoa, Droste, he may forgive us our sins.
Τοβε με ψόισε ρέιε, γονενιώτες ο άβινα βισκόπος, Ava Yosef Nimava Peter Tifkan in Novina Nevol. So er is on Sibon Finiman Choisi Tarken Hito, but in Chosen Nipterentis Otto Kosute Ambar Senus in Sayoniven.
Ask of him whom you have borne, our good Savior, to take away our troubles and grant us his peace.
Sherenioti Parthenus Orem. Μην αλήθινοι, σερεψούσον τέβεν γένος αρέκφων άνιν εμμένουιλ.
We ask you to remember us, our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
We exalt you, the Mother of the true light, we glorify you, O Saint, the Theotokos. For you have brought forth unto us the Savior of the whole world. He came and saved our souls. Glory be to you, our Master, our King, Christ, the pride of the apostles, the crown of the martyrs, the joy of the righteous, the firmness of the churches,
forgiveness of sins.
We proclaim the Holy Trinity in one Godhead. We worship him. We glorify him. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, bless us. Amen. Truly, we believe in one God, God the Father, the Pontus Creator, who created heaven and earth. All things seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father,
by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, was incarnated of the Holy Spirit in the bosom of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
And he was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried. On the third day he rose from the dead, according to the scriptures, ascended into the heavens. He sits at the right hand of his Father. He is coming again in his glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. Yes, we believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the life giver, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And in one holy Catholic apostolic church, we confess one baptism for the remission of sins.
Amen.
us.
Amen.
Take away your anger from us. Visit us with your salvation and forgive us our sin.
Amen.
Desire to see a single see, I have not seen them, and to hear the thing which you have not heard them. But as for you, blessed are your eyes, for his see and your ears, for they he may purge to hear and to act according to your holy gospels. Through the prayers of your saints.
Pray for the Holy Gospel.
Lord, have mercy.
O Scribe سيدنا كل الذين أوصون من أسكن في صلتنا تدرعاتنا التي نرفعها إليه إيك أيها رب إلهنا الذين سبقوا فرقدوا يا رب نيحهم مرضى شعبك أشفيهم لأن كانت حياتنا كلنا رجعنا كلنا خلاصنا كلنا شفعنا كلنا قيامتنا كلنا
Псалм Су Давид.
Ти на он на
Oh.
خنت اكليسيا انت بفلاوس وماروس موير فيت كاتدرا انت نبرز فيتيروس جاف كونو متيوت مفريتنا نسو افن اف ان اف انجينيا سوتونو اف ارنوف افور كنجيب شو سو انفهم انثيف جان سوك بف وبشاين قطع التاكسي سمل شي سيدك شو يسوي نام مكبنيوت سوا بطريارشيس بابا باتا ودرس بما هسناف نمنف كيش فيرن ليتر غوسن ابوستوليكون نينيوتي سوى بنبس قوبس افا يوسف نمافا بيتر نيتكي نيمن شوي سفي عري اي بيتن اون خليلويا
Metavovo Theo, a cosumento agio, if on
تن جيفس نيو خنا فران بريسن تاني غوم كير يا فلوغي سونك توكاتا ماثي اون اجيو افانجينيو توانا نوسما
خوف أمام الله وانصتوا لسماع الإنجيل المقدس فصل من بشارة الإنجيل لمعلمنا ماري متى البشير التلميذ الطاهر بركاته
على
مزامير أبينا داود النبي والملك بركاته على جميعنا أمين أعترف لك يا رب باستقامة قلبي إذا عرفت أحكام عدلك وحقوقك أحفظها كنيسة شعبه وليباركوا على منابر الشيوخ لأنه جعل الأبوة مثل الخراف يبصر المستقيمون ويفرحون أقسم الرب ولن يندم أنك أنت هو الكاهن إلى الأبد على تقسم الكيصادك الرب عن يمينك يا أبانا القديس البابا الأنبا تودرس الثاني وشركائك في الخدمة الرسولية أبائنا الأساقف المكرمين الأنبا يوسف والأنبا بيطار الرب يحفظ لنا حياتكم
آمين
والآتي باسم الرب ربنا وإلهنا ومخلصنا ربنا يسوع المسيح الذي له المجد الدائم
إلى الأبد آمين.
وللوقت ألزم تلاميذه أن يركبوا السفينة ويسبقوه إلى العبر حتى يصرف الجموع. وبعدما صرف الجموع صعد إلى الجبل على انفراد ليصلي. ولما صار المساء كان هناك وحده، أما السفينة فكانت بعيدة عن البر نحو 25 غلوة معذبة من الأمواج لأن الريح كانت مضادة. وفي الهزيع الرابع من الليل جاء إليهم ماشيا على البحر، فلما رآه تلاميذه ماشيا على البحر اضطربوا قائلين إنه خيال، ومن الخوف صرخوا. فللوقت كلمهم قائلا تشجعوا أنا لا تخافوا. فأجاب بطرس وقال له يا رب إن كنت أنت هو فمرني أن آتي إليك على الماء. فقال له تعالى. فنزل بطرس من السفينة ومشى على الماء ليأتي إلى يسوع. ولما رأى الريح خاف، وإذ ابتدأ يغرق صرخ قائلا يا رب نجني. فللوقت مد يسوع يده وأمسكه وقال له يا قليل الإيمان لماذا شككت؟ فلما ركب السفينة سكنت الريح، والذين كانوا في السفينة سجدوا له قائلين بالحقيقة أنت ابن الله. فلما عبروا دخلوا إلى أرض جنيسار، فعرفه رجال ذلك المكان وأرسلوا إلى جميع تلك القرى المحيطة وقدموا إليه جميع السقماء وطلبوا إليه أن يلمسوا هدب ثوبه فقط. فجميع الذين لمسوه خالصوا.
والمجد لله مرنشتم بن صوتير بمعرم حوشنت قارون أبي أوف صوتهم من الرزب
فيما ليكن وتتوسل نفتر انت سيوتو قسم علي أسمع بن صوتير انت كان النوضي
الرزب بين ليكن وبعرش أنجلوسيس هو ابن خير بارخنا نفعو انت كان النوضي نانيبول أبا يوسف نمابا بيتر تفكان النبي نانيبول جيفز مارون جيف يوم يمشير نمبب نمما يصوب تدري ياسد جيكيب تنوش المستنيون
شلي لفلوق يسون
بيبروسف شيستاسي
ايرين باسي Has got the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. We ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, the peace of the one only holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Pray for the peace of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church of God.
Lord, have mercy.
Again, let us ask the Pantocrator. هذه الكائنة من أقصى المسكونة إلى أقصاها. Remember, O Lord, our patriarch, the honored father, the up, Theodore the second, his partners in the apostolic liturgy, our fathers, the bishops, Papa Yusuf and Papa Peter.
Pray for Archpriest Pope Abba Theodore the second, Pope and Patriarch and Archbishop of the great city of Alexandria, and his partners in the apostolic liturgy, our fathers, the Bishop Abba Yusuf and Abba Peter, and for our Orthodox bishops.
Lord, have mercy.
Keep them for us for peaceful times.
Remember, O Lord, salvation of the holy place and every place and every monastery of our Orthodox fathers.
Pray for the salvation of the world and of this city of ours and of all cities, districts, islands, and monasteries.
Lord, have mercy.
وكل مدينة وكل كورة والكرة وكل زينتها ونجينا كلنا من الغلاء والوباء والزلازل والغرق والحريق وسبي البربر ومن سيف الغريب ومن قيام الهراطقة
يا رب ارحم.
Graciously accord, O Lord, the seeds and the herbs and the plants of the field this year to plant them.
Pray for the seeds, the herbs, and the plants of the field this year, that Christ our God may bless them to grow and multiply unto perfection with great fruit. Have compassion on his creation which his hands have made, and forgive us our sins.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Read them according to their measure, according to your grace, give joy to the face of the earth. May its fruits be abundantly watered, and its fruits be plentiful. Prepare for sowing and harvesting, manage our life as deemed fit. Bless the crown of the year with your goodness, for the sake of the poor of your people, the widows, the orphans, the travelers, the stranger, and for the sake of all of us who entreat and deceive. Take your holy name, for the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food, and you, season, deal with us according to your goodness, O you give food to all flesh, fill our hearts with joy and gladness, that we having sufficiency in everything, always may abound in every good
deed.
Again, let us ask God the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. We ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, our assembly.
Pray for this holy church and for our assemblies.
Lord have mercy.
أعطي أن تكون لنا بغير مانع ولا عائق لنصنعها كما شئتك المقدسة الطوباوية. بيوت صلاة بيوت طهارة بيوت بركة انعم بها لنا يا رب والعبيدك الآتي من بعدنا إلى الأبد. قوم أيها الرب الإله وليتبدد جميع أعدائك وليهرب من قدام وجهك كل مبغضي اسمك القدوس. أما شعبك فليكن بالبركة ألوف ألوف وربوات ربوات يصنعون إرادتك. And make us worthy to breathe thankfully, our Father.
Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Christ Jesus, our Lord.
And where is those eason venchoi?
Aski philosophy meon to get a clinote.
In obion so kire ye.
Os comen theometo vovomen.
Irin a passi.
Et omneumati so.
Rabbi Yasu al Messi, Ibn al Wahid, الذي قطع كل ربطات خطايانا من قبل آلام المخلص المحيي الذي نفخ في وجوه تلاميذه القديسين ورسل الأطهار. قائلاً اقبلوا روح قدس من غفرتم لهم خطاياهم غفرة ومن أمسكتموه عليهم أمسكت. أنت الآن يا سيدنا من كبار رسل الأطهار أنعمت على الذين يعملون في كهنوت في كنيستك المقدسة أن يغفروا الخطايا لأرض وربطوا وحلوا كل ربطات الظلم. الآن أيضا نسألك من صلاحك يا محب البشر عن أبي الأسقف والكهنة والشمامسة والإكليروس وكل الشعب وضعفي على المحيا برؤوس أمام مجدك المقدس. سكن رحمتك اقطع عنا كل ربطات خطايانا إن كنا قد أخطأنا إليك بشيء بعلم أو بغير علم بجزع القلب بسبب القلب. فأنت أيها السيد العارف بضعف البشر كصالح محب البشر اللهم انعم لنا بغفران خطايانا باركنا طهرنا وحاللنا وحالل سائر شعبك من
من الليلو يا دوك سابتري هيوك أجيب نوماني كنين كاين إسوس يوانا سون يوانا تنوش يوانين قوين مجيب بن شوي سيزول بي اسمونا إيرن تيت في نمني موه مفيارو نمني سيتي نمني سماري بك ناين تكيريني هاي صبتن بك لأو ستين مونو ناينا شيت خاليس موي سيستيمت اوي بنتي ملشي تيمت خلو انتي ياقوب بينو قنا انتي مثوسا بيكاتي صد بنتي دافي تي صوفيها انتي صد بيبن مان برك ليدون في دافي جيني ابوس ابشوي سفي عري بون نمتا ويرات في بنيوت الطايوت نعشي ريفس بابا غطاوة نم بنيوت نيبس قبص عافا يوسف نم بنيوت نيبس قبص عافا بي ابنوت انتد في فتاك روحي جنو اسرونوس نعن ميشن رمي نمان سيئو بنيري انت افسفيو انو داجي تيرو صابا سيت انو اتشالف جين كل طب بخريسو سريا دون تفكان انو بنان انو ايرين قلاب ابنشتن كريا ليسون كريا ليسون Kyrie ευλογήσον αμήν εσμοε, εσμοε ρο εστιματάν Ιακών ευλογών ποι εσμο.
Δε Χριστούς πενούτι.
Αμήν εσέσον.
Ik oren te tieren in mijn naan te keren, in zijn naan te keren, in je keren novena nivol. Je zocht het die gom, in pion, in pismon, in pion, maïsheni, I mean, make us worry to pray thankfully. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. In Christ Jesus, our Lord, for thine the kingdom, the power, the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. وقطعت رأسه في روما أيامه.
بيباركنا ويشرفنا النهاردة وبيزود فرحتنا اثنين من الأحبار الأجلاء نيافة الحبر الجليل لأنبا يوسف ونيافة الحبر الجليل لأنبا كراس. بنشكرهم على حضورهم كثيرا برغم سفريات ومشاغل سيدنا نيافة أنبا يوسف، لكن لما قلت له سيدنا عرسامة قبل الدعوة على طول، برغم أن سيدنا النهاردة كان جاي من سفر برا أمريكا، يعني جاي من أوفرسيز، لكن إحنا بنشكر سيدنا تلبية الدعوة وربنا يخليك لينا. يعني زي ما أنتوا عارفين نيافة أنبا يوسف هو أبويا ومعلمي، تعلمت على يديه الكثير والكثير. يمكن بعضكم يحس أن أنا بتكلم كلام إنش، مش كده؟ لكن لا صح؟ مصدقيني يعني؟ طيب very good. لكن يمكن الوحيد اللي يعرف صدق هذا الكلام هو سيدنا، لأن سيدنا الوحيد اللي عارف هو عمل معايا إيه روحياً. بنشكرك كثير ان سيدنا على حضورك وربنا يخليك لينا، وبنفرح دايما لما بنشوفك. يعني الواحد بيحس ان ليه ظهر وسند كده، مش كده ولا ايه؟ ها؟ بنشكر ايضا حضور حضره صاحب النيافه الحبر الجليل أنبا كراس. أنبا كراس برضو كان عنده رسامه النهارده، اب كاهن، بنهنيه ونقول له ألف مبروك سيدنا وتعيش وترسم. وأرجو قبول اعتذاري على عدم الحضور، يعني أخطيت، المرة الجاية إن شاء الله تتعوض إن شاء الله. أيضا أبلغكم اعتذار نيافة الحبر الجليل المطران الأنبا سرابي، إن هو سيدنا كان المفروض يحضر النهاردة معنا، لكن لظرف طارئ حصل، فبيقدم اعتذاره يعني ليكم، وإن شاء الله نشوفه في مناسبة أخرى. كما أشكر حضور أبائي الكهنة الموجودين معنا، ربنا يعوض الجميع عن كل الذين يشاركون فرحتنا، وربنا يجعل كل أيامنا أفراح بإذن الله. ودلوقتي نسمع كلمات النعمة من فم أبينا نيافة الحبر الجليل أنبا يوسف.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. I like to thank God that He gave me this opportunity to be with you tonight, celebrating the first ordination of His Grace, Bishop Peter. After his ordination and his enthronement as the bishop of this blessed diocese, I congratulate Sayyidina for this ordination, and I ask all of you to pray for the candidate that God may support him with the grace of the Holy Spirit, and bless his ministry for the glory of his holy name. And also let us pray for more and more blessed ordinations in this diocese, so the diocese will be fruitful and bear, as the Lord Jesus Christ said, 30, 60, and 100-fold. And also, we like to congratulate His Grace Bishop Karas for ordaining a priest this morning. May the Lord bless this ministry, this ordination in the diocese also of Pennsylvania, for the glory of His holy name. And also I like to thank the choir for the beautiful songs that they presented to us in Coptic, in English, in Arabic. All of them were participating. And one of the songs, actually, it is from the Syrian Orthodox Church, هي الترنيمة بتاعت العذراء، ثلاث حمامات. So it's beautiful song, and I noticed that all the children were participating, all of them. فيعني مكود كويس. We thank them for this effort, and we thank those who taught them and the parents for cooperating with the activity in the church. And also I'd like to congratulate you for this beautiful church and the addition of this service building to the church. ربنا يبارك في كل عمل وفي كل خدمة لمجد اسمه القدوس. One of the common sins of the tongue is the sin of lying. And it is easy to see why people lie to others. Many of us, we justify lying. Maybe some of us lie to avoid argument. Others lie to keep their reputation. Others lie that everyone will think good about them. It is wrong, it is a sin, but sometimes all of us, we fall into this sin, the sin of lying. But tonight, I like to speak with you about a certain type of lying, which is not lying to others, but lying to ourselves. Lying to ourselves. Maybe we think, no, I don't lie to myself. Why do I lie to myself? But in reality, it happens, as I will tell you, it happens quite often that we lie to ourselves and we are very good at it. And sometimes we believe our lies, that we lie to ourselves. For example, if a new gadget, new phone, came in the market, I convinced myself that I really need it in order to justify buying it. And in reality, I'm lying to myself. But why I'm convincing myself I really need this phone just to justify to myself that I will buy this new gadget? Many times we know that we made a wrong financial decision, but we lie to ourselves and we defend our decision that it is a wise financial choice, and wise financial decision. And we try to convince ourselves and others, and then actually we believe this lie that our decision was the best decision financially. Many times we believe that everything is fine. I don't have problem. Like a person who smokes cigarette or using drugs or alcohol or gambling, they lie to themselves and they say, I don't have problem. I can quit smoking at any time. I can quit drinking at any time. I don't have problem with gambling. Although they have problem, but they lie to themselves. Even if the evidence proves otherwise, or otherwise, we stick to our lies and we refuse to say the truth even to ourselves. When we lie to ourselves, we hurt ourselves. It is harmful to us. It's harmful to our well-being. And in spite of this, we still lie to ourselves. So why do we lie to ourselves? And how, what is the importance of being honest with yourself and how to stop lying to ourselves? These are the three points I like to address tonight. Why we lie to ourselves the importance of honesty to one's self, and how, what are the practical steps in order to quit lying to ourselves. There are at least three reasons why we lie to ourselves. The first reason, we want to be right. We want to be right. Our actions, our attitude, and our beliefs should line up together. So when I perform an action that goes against my belief, I will not feel comfortable. When I perform an action that goes against my belief system, I will feel uncomfortable. And in order actually to get rid of this feeling, being uncomfortable, we try to justify our action or to change my belief system in order to get rid of this negative feeling. I am uncomfortable. I am uncomfortable. For example, in the Old Testament, Samson, as a Nazarite, he should not actually go to Timna, because Timna has grapes and vineyards, and it was a city of wine. And as a Nazarite of the Lord, he should not drink wine, he should not shave his hair, and also he should not touch any dead body. These are the three requirements of a Nazarite. But because he loved a woman there in Timna, so he broke actually one of the three vows, and he went to Timna, the city of the wine, although as a Nazarite he should not go there. And he decided to marry this woman. And when his parents tried to convince him otherwise, he did not listen to them. And he tried actually to justify his action by saying to his parents, "She pleases me well. She pleases me well." So here he was lying to himself. Why he was lying to himself? He knew that his action goes against his vows as a Nazarite. But in order to get rid of this uncomfortable feeling, that's why he gave this excuse that she pleases me well. And if you continue and reading the story of Samson, you will see how this woman was dishonest, was unfaithful to him, and at the end actually her father gave this woman as a wife to one of his best friends, and ended up the story by Samson burning all the fields and all the belonging of this woman with her father's house. So here why Samson lied to himself, because he wanted to be right, and he defended his action to himself in order to get rid of this feeling of discomfort. Many times, in order to reduce the feeling of discomfort or the guilt, we say, everyone else is doing it, so it is okay. Nothing wrong with it. and we try to justify what we are doing. But there is a very important question here. What is the price we pay to be right? What is the price we pay to be right? Actually, we are letting go of an opportunity to improve ourselves. We are letting go of an opportunity to practice something right and to grow in it. That is the price, and can be actually the price in we lose our eternity. Another story in the scripture, the story of King Saul. I used to think and to compare between King Saul and King David. The sin of King Saul, actually, if you compare it with the sin of David, it's nothing. God told him, kill all the animals, but he spared some animals. David, on the other side, committed adultery and committed murder. But God said about David, a man after my own heart. And he said about Saul, I rejected him. And he said to Samuel, why are you praying for him? I rejected him. Stop praying for him. God doesn't have partiality. Why God actually said about David, a man after my own heart, and he rejected Saul? Because Saul lied to himself. When God sent Samuel to rebuke Saul, Saul lied to himself. And he said, I complied with the commandment of God. And when Samuel confronted him and he told him, what is the voice of these animals that's coming to my ear? He told him, yes, we spared some animals to offer sacrifices to the Lord your God. When Samuel told him, God is pleased with obedience more than with sacrifices, he started to give another excuse. I was afraid of the people. And so on. Saul here was lying to himself. But David, when God sent to him Nathan and rebuked him, David confessed his sin and he said, I have sinned against God. Saul wanted to be right. That's why God rejected him. But when David condemned himself and he said, I am wrong, I am a sinner, I have sinned against God, God forgave him. And actually, that is confession. That's repentance and confession. Many of us, when we go for confession, we go to prove that we are right. And we go and we defend our sins before Abuna. This will not help us. Because if you are right, then you don't need absolution. You don't need forgiveness. But if I go to confession and say, I am wrong, I have sinned, like the prodigal son, then I will hear the voice full of joy, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. Another reason why we lie to ourselves, because we want to avoid change. We don't want to do any changes. For example, if somebody in a toxic relationship, in a poisonous relationship, the solution is clear. You need to leave this relationship. But although the answer is very, very clear, very obvious, and many, maybe friends or parents or abuna, point out red flag, this relationship is toxic. You cannot marry this girl, you cannot marry this boy. But we refuse. Again, if we're gonna go back to the story of Samson, Samson with Delilah, this relationship was very toxic. We read about Samson in this relationship that his soul was vexed to death. He was oppressed to the point of death. So the solution is very clear. Leave. But he did not leave. Actually, Delilah told him, tell me what is the reason of your strength that I may deliver you to the hands of the Philistines to torture you. So she did not trick him. She told him her plan very clearly. And Samson lied to her 3 times. And she brought the Philistines to torture Samson. So why Samson did not leave her? Because he held on to false belief that Philistines cannot defeat me. He lied to himself. And this false belief ended up by him being tortured by the Philistines. Some of us, we refuse actually to change or to be honest with ourselves because of the fear of the change, the fear of change. We hold on to old things and we refuse to let go. And in this way, actually, we refuse and we reject new ideas, new opportunities, to give opportunities to new people in our life. And many times, we take our lie to ourselves a step further when we confirm this lie and we defend this lie. For example, if I'm doing bad in my job and somebody is telling me, you need to change your way, you need to improve, you cannot continue like this. So I defend myself and defend my lie and I say something like, my boss loves me, my boss compliments me. No, I am doing a good job. So not only I'm lying to myself, but I am actually trying to confirm this lie, Why people fear to change or avoid to change? Because we invested some time, we invested some effort. That's why I don't want to waste this effort or this time. But at the end, if I refuse to change, the loss will be greater and greater. So we need to learn how to be honest with ourselves and to stop lying to ourselves in order, even if we waste some investment, in order actually to take advantage of every opportunity to improve and to grow. The third reason why we lie to ourselves, I said the first reason because we want to be right. Second reason, we want to avoid change. Third reason, we do not want to get hurt. So sometimes we lie to ourselves because I say, I don't want to be the troublemaker. If Saint Athanasius took the same idea, he would lie to himself and say, nothing wrong about what Arius is saying. Maybe I misunderstood the Bible. Maybe when Jesus said, my Father is greater than I, this means that he is less than the Father. And if St. Athanasius convinced himself with this lie, what would be the reason behind it? The reason, he didn't want to get hurt. He didn't want to get in trouble. But St. Athanasius refused to lie to himself. And he was honest. And he defended the truth, although he paid a very high price. And this high price was he was exiled 5 times by Emperor Constantine. And he was away from his throne for a very long time. In many situations, we convince ourselves with a lie against our belief system so that we will not speak the truth in order to avoid getting in trouble or getting hurt. The word of truth has cost, has price. But in order to avoid this price and this cost, so we convince ourselves with a lie and we defend this lie so that we will not get hurt in the process. So these are the common 3 reasons why people do not or are not honest with themselves, either because you want to be right or to avoid change or not to be hurt. But we need actually to learn how to listen to ourselves, to listen to ourselves. What actually differentiates each one of us? It's our interest, our hobbies, our personalities. These things that differentiate each one of us. Many times when somebody is different than me in his hobby, in his personality, in his interest, I find a reason not to like this person. And I convince myself with a lie that this person is bad. In reality, I don't like this person not because he is bad, but because he is different from me. If we examine our relationship with one another, we find that some people we don't like just because they are different, not because they did anything wrong to us, just they are different. But if you say to yourself, I don't like this person because he is different, this doesn't sound right. That's why we try to find reasons to justify to ourselves why we don't like these people. And we try to prove to ourselves that these people are bad. That's why I am not comfortable with them. Many times in our relationship, we lie to ourselves about others just to justify why I don't like this person. But my advice here, if you find in your life a person who is different from you, and you don't feel comfortable around him, I want you to listen to yourself and to think about it. Maybe this person is not bad. Maybe this person is just different from you. And nothing wrong to say he is different. You don't have to come up with a reason that he is bad. That's why you don't feel comfortable around him. Or maybe this person reminds you with a negative experience in your childhood. Maybe this person reminds you with another person who hurt you in your childhood, in your youth. So be honest with yourself and listen to yourself and see why you are not comfortable around this person. The scribe and the Pharisees were not honest with themselves. They tried to prove that Jesus is a bad person. He breaks the Sabbath. He does not keep the commandment of God. He does not keep the law of Moses. And they lied to themselves. That's why they conspired to kill him. And the real reason, it was envy and jealousy. They were jealous of the Lord Jesus Christ. But they were not honest with themselves. If they were honest with themselves, they would say, we are jealous of the Lord Jesus. That's why we want to kill him. But they justified to themselves and they lied to themselves and they believed that he broke the law of Moses. That's why they said his blood is upon us and upon our children. The Lord Jesus Christ several times tried to make them honest with themselves. Like when he gave them the parable of the wicked vine dressers. At the end of the parable, we hear they knew that he said this parable about them. So they knew this parable about them. Instead of repenting, instead of being honest with themselves, they conspired how to kill the Lord Jesus Christ. And until now, we do the same. We do the same. Many people in our life, we don't like them, and we try to justify it, as the scribe and Pharisee justified why they don't like the Lord Jesus Christ, in order to cover a lie, which is, for the scribe and Pharisees, they were jealous of the Lord Jesus Christ. They were threatened. They were intimidated by him. They were threatened lest he take the popularity from them or he take the people from them. But St. John the Baptist, on the other wise, when the people told him that Jesus is baptizing and making more friends, more disciples than you, John the Baptist was honest with himself. He said, I'm not the bridegroom. I am the friend of the bridegroom. It's natural that Jesus increases and I decrease. He was honest with himself. But the scribe and Pharisees on the other side were not honest with themselves. Many times we avoid sitting and examining ourselves and opening to ourselves about why you feel this way and why we act this way. To be honest with yourself takes strength. When you act in a certain way, when you feel angry, when you lose your temper, when you act rude with somebody, when you have negative feeling toward a certain person or toward a certain situation, you need to be honest with yourself. Honesty takes strength. Honesty takes strength. But at the end, honesty will heal you and will make you a better person. It is much easier to lie to yourself and to justify the negative feeling and to justify the negative behavior and to justify the negative attitude. It's very easy. But your problem will remain the same. But when you become honest with yourself, then yes, your wounds will be revealed. But when your wounds are revealed, they will be treated. Like when you go to a physician and he does some investigation, an X-ray, an MRI, then my wounds are revealed, then I can start the treatment. But if my wounds are covered with a lie, then I will never be treated. Yes, it is not easy to uncover the truth. But once we do, once we see everything clearly, we are giving ourselves a chance to make changes and to improve and to be healed. That's why honesty and being honest with yourself is a huge part of self-improvement and overcoming our delusions. If we continue to lie to ourselves, then we'll never learn and we'll never grow as individuals. When we are dishonest and when we lie to ourselves, we only choose to see what we want to see, but we ignore what we do not want to see. Maybe this will give me short-term happiness or relief. But in the long run, it is unhealthy and destructive. I am sure the scribes and Pharisees, when they crucified the Lord Jesus Christ, it gave them short-term happiness and relief. We got rid of him. Now he is dead and he is buried. But when the news of resurrection came, they start to suffer. That's why they want to kill the apostles. It irritated them, the preaching of resurrection. Being honest with ourselves is painful, but it is a necessary component if you want to be happy and successful in your life. The sacrament of confession is about being honest with yourself. That's the sacrament of confession. But if you go to confession and try to justify your feelings and try to justify your behavior and complain about others and blame others for your behavior, you will never be treated. That's what Adam and Eve did. They blamed one another. Adam blamed Eve. Eve blamed the serpent. That's why, you know, they were not healed at that time. So, what are the practical steps of to be honest with yourself? We spoke about why people lie to themselves. And we spoke about the importance of being honest with ourselves. Now we'll speak about what are the practical steps of being honest with yourself. One actually of the very, very beautiful Psalms is Psalm 139. 139 starts, O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You understand my thought afar off. So David continued to explain how God knew everything about him. That's why at the end of the psalm, in verse 23 and 24, he said, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my anxieties. And see if there is any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting." And I like every one of us to pray these two verses on a daily basis. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my anxieties. And see if there is any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. It is the work of the Holy Spirit to search us. As the Lord said, when the Holy Spirit comes, He will convict us of sin, righteousness, and judgment. That's why we need actually to examine ourselves and ask the Holy Spirit to search our heart. One of the desert fathers said, "The day in which you do not examine yourself, don't consider it a day of your life." We need to examine ourselves daily. Just take 5 to 10 minutes every night to reflect on your day. Ask yourself, after you pray and ask the Holy Spirit to search your heart, ask yourself, how did things go today? What did I do right? What could I have done better? What are my feelings this day? Why I felt this way? Why I had this attitude? Be honest with yourself. Don't be too judgmental or overcritical. Because the goal here is not to hurt yourself. But the goal is to take the information of today and use it to improve tomorrow. The goal is to take the information of today and use it to improve tomorrow. Even the scientific studies proved that daily reflection plays a key role in learning and problem solving. Because when you give yourself every day time to analyze the event of day, you can actually get greater knowledge and insight how to improve yourself and how to deal with situations in a different way, in a better way. So the first advice, to be honest with yourself, take time to reflect every day. Start this time by prayer. Say these two verses from Psalm 139. Ask the Holy Spirit to search your heart, to see if there is a wicked way, and to lead me in a way everlasting. And after this, ask yourself about how this day went, your feeling, your action, your behavior, your attitude, and how to do things better for a better tomorrow. Number two, when you examine yourself, acknowledge both good and bad in your life. If you focus only on what you did good, you may fall in pride. If you focus only on what you did bad, you may fall in depression and despair. That's why keep the balance between what you did good through the grace of God and what you did bad. Many of us, we turn a blind eye to our negatives instead of confronting them. Because when we ignore these negatives, we feel better. But as I said, it is a short term. And when you turn a blind eye to the negatives in your life, you will not fix them. You will not fix them. And when we are not honest about our problems, they will grow out of control. They will grow out of control. But when we actually address our problems when they are small, we can actually handle them better. God in His love, He will send you every day some people will tell you about what you need to improve and what you need to change. Don't be defensive. Listen carefully. If Herod listened to John the Baptist and did not kill him, maybe he would have saved his life. If Judas listened to the many warnings that the Lord Jesus Christ gave him, maybe he wouldn't betray the Lord. But he did not listen. Many times the Lord sends us every day, somebody tell us, you're wrong. Why you are angry? Why you have an attitude? This is not right. But once somebody criticizes me or make a negative comment about me, we turn to be defensive and to justify. Just listen. Maybe this is an opportunity for you to improve yourself. That's why the third point, admit when you make mistakes. Admit it. Nobody is perfect. And nothing wrong actually to say, I have sinned or I did this wrong. His Holiness Pope Shenouda used to say, God will not question you why you did this sin or why you did this mistake. Because if God questioned us this question, the answer is very easy. We are human beings, we are weak. But God will ask you why you did not repent. And repentance starts by admitting our own mistakes. So, when you examine yourself, admit it when you made mistake in your life. One of the most painful thing about being honest is to say, I am wrong. It's painful to say. That's why to protect our ego, we come up with excuses or we blame others for our problems. But actually, true self-esteem is found only when we are comfortable and honest about our mistakes and about our shortcoming. Only the person who admits his mistakes can learn from them and correct them. But if we ignore our mistake, we are setting ourselves to repeat them again and again and again. So take time to reflect on yourself. Keep the balance between what's good and what's bad. Admit your mistake. Number four, pay attention to your feelings. Pay attention to your feelings. All of us, we experience emotions. And emotions play an important role in understanding the world around us. Sometimes emotions can be misleading, but emotions also can be very revealing. Ask yourself about the true cause behind your emotion. Why I am happy in this situation? Why I was edgy in this situation? Why I was depressed? Why I was angry? Try to understand your emotion. Try to understand why you are experiencing what you are experiencing. Actually, when you do this, you will learn about yourself more. And you will learn what thoughts or actions or situation can cause you to feel in a certain way. This knowledge is very important because it will give you better understanding of yourself and how to respond to your emotions differently in the future. Again, in the scripture, if the scribes and Pharisees were honest with their emotions around the Lord Jesus Christ, maybe they would have repented. Nicodemus was honest about his emotion, but he was afraid. That's why he went to see the Lord at night. The parents of the blind man, they were not honest with their emotions. That's why they were afraid lest they cast them out of the synagogue if they said Jesus is the one who healed our son. So they said, he's of old age, go and ask him. They were not honest, but if they actually took time to reflect on their emotion, why we answered their question this way, we knew that Jesus is the one who healed him, why we refused to answer? Yes, because I'm afraid. Why am I afraid? Because I loved the glory of men more than the glory of God, as the Bible says. It's very important to examine your emotion and to understand why you are feeling the way you are feeling. Another point, know that your knowledge is limited. Only one who is all knowledgeable, that's God. Be aware of your limitation. This is part of being honest with yourself, to be aware of your limitation. Our knowledge is imperfect, and many things we don't know, many things we don't understand. If you are a Sunday school servant, or even a clergy, and somebody asked you a question and you do not know the answer, nothing wrong to say, I don't know. But to assume that you are all knowledgeable and have answer for everything, this is part of being dishonest with yourself. A group of monks went to visit Saint Anthony the Great. And Saint Anthony was asking them questions. So one of them did not answer. And his name was Abba Yusuf. So Saint Anthony the Great asked him, why you are not answering? So he said, because I do not know. So Saint Anthony the Great replied and told him, blessed are you because you knew the way to I do not know. You knew the way to, I do not know. Being honest about what we do not know keeps us humble and realistic. But if we assume we know everything, we will act in a stubborn and irrational way. And we also ignore evidence that may contradict our current belief. Many times when parents give their children advice, the children assume they know better than their parents. So they act in a stubborn way, in a rebellious way. But if the children are honest with themselves and they say, my parents are wiser than me and have more experience than me, and listen to them, actually this can save them a lot of troubles. Understanding our limitation keeps us open to new information and knowledge. Also, this allows us to be more flexible, and we can modify certain things in our belief system to learn something new. So, to be honest with yourself, you need to understand and to respect your limitation. Another point, when you examine yourself, don't be over-critical or over-analytical. Some people actually, they over-analyze every situation and they become over-critical. When we are over-analytical or over-critical, most of the time the conclusion is wrong. That's why, although self-analysis is very important element in our self-improvement and being honest with ourselves, but over-analysis and over-criticism can actually hurt us. So just be straightforward and don't complicate things. Don't make theories and assume things, especially if what we assume is worse than the reality, and how we interpret others is worse than the reality. Just be simple and make note of how things are in the moment and how you understand them in a very simple way, just enough to be practical, realistic, and sensible. The last point I like to mention, that honesty with oneself takes time. It does not happen overnight. Not just because you heard a sermon about honesty with oneself, then you will leave from here honest with yourself. No. Honesty takes practice. It is something that we need to practice on a daily basis. And when we start from tonight, searching ourselves, praying to God to examine our hearts, our feelings, our emotions, when we are constantly self-aware, when we are vigilant about ourselves, then gradually we will develop this virtue, the virtue of honesty with ourselves. Yes, being honest with ourselves can be painful, but it is highly rewarding, especially when honesty meets with our willingness to change. So it's not enough to be honest, but with honesty, you need to be willing to change and take the steps to improve and to grow. This is the only way to grow and to improve and to change from image to image in order to be in the image and likeness of our Lord Jesus Christ. May God help us to search ourselves and to know what are the wicked ways in ourselves, to reveal our lies to ourselves in order to lead us in a way everlasting. And glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.
Es monair in tet fen im nimoe me fiaron im nisitin im nisem mare bec nain im tic ois optem bec leos otem mono von ainan ac cit cheris em moisis timet o iben timet
sedek timet chelo in te Jacobin ogina in te matho
Salavit, atetzot ben te David, tiso veien te sorom.
On bi ebnev ma paraklit, on fiet a fie jenni apostolos.
Eb choise fiare, eb okhlev tau, erat fin ben yot, et tayot en asheref, baba avata, vaduro. Nem den yot in ebis, kobis nit, ki nim en if not in ted.
Ve efet agrohi, jenno etronos, nahan mishem romni, nem han seyo en herini kon
entem savyo en no daji tiro sabasit no et chalav gen kore
dove be christos ere egon tef kain en novina ne volchen o herini kata befne shten
na kirie rei son kirie rei son kirie vage son amin esmoe esmoe roi istima tania konie evol gombi esmoe
Christos benoti
Amines Ashobi.
O King of Peace, grant us your peace, establish your peace, and forgive us our sins. For you, the power, the glory, the majesty forever. Amen. Make us worthy to say thankfully, Our Father.
Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. Christ Jesus our Lord, who represents the kingdom, the power, the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Now the love of God, Father, and the grace of only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the gift of the Holy Spirit be with you. Go in peace. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dimites noten areti. Embebneuma eth o Amen.
Yeah.
من تحل على رأس أبينا القديس رئيس الكهنة البابا أنبت ودروس وشركائه في الخدمة الرسولية آبائنا المكرمين الأساقفة المجتمعين معنا تي ما هفتو تأبي طوفو تي ما هتيو تأتي قرثانية تي ما أحصو سواب انارشي اي 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 بابا ابوتا كشفيرن لي طرغاس إن أبوستولي قوس نينيوتي إس أواب هنبس قابا واب
حتى ما اعرفش لكل الناس وحتى ما اعرفش I'll be here by 7:15.
I expect you. I'll be here 7:30.
I'll get a picture.